वेलकम टू एक्सपर्ट ओके सॉरी वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक 6M सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. मायसेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग एंड इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर. टूडेज टॉपिक इज एक्सपर्ट सिस्टम्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ decision theoretic expert systems. The field of decision analysis which evolved in the 1950s and 1960s studies the application of decision theory to actual decision problem. It is used to help make rational decisions in important domains where the stakes are high, such as business, government, law, military, strategy, medical, public health, etc. And the process involves a careful study of the possible actions and outcomes as well as the preference placed on each outcome. And it is traditional in decision analysis to talk about two roles: the decision maker states preference between outcomes, and the decision analyst enumerates the possible actions and outcomes and elicits preference from the decision maker to determine the best source of action, best course of actions. And until the early 1980s, the main purpose of decision analysis was to help human make decisions that actually reflect their own preferences. As more and more decision processes becomes automated, decision analysis is increasingly used to ensure that the automated processes are being behaving as desired. So early expert systems research concentrated on answering questions rather than on making decisions. Those systems that did recommend actions rather than providing opinions on matters of fact generally did so using condition action rules rather than with explicit representation of outcomes and preferences. And the emergence of Bayesian networks in the late 1980s made it possible to build large-scale system that generated sound probability inferences from evidence. And the addition of decision networks means that expert system can be developed that recommend optimal decision and reflecting the preferences of the agent as well as the available evidence. So the system that incorporates utilities can avoid one of the most common pitfalls associated with the consultation process, confusing likelihood and importance. And a common strategy in early medical expert system, for example, was to rank possible diagnoses in order of likelihood and report the most likely. And for the majority of patients in general practice, the two most likely diagnoses are usually that there is nothing wrong with you and you have a bad cold. But if the third most likely diagnosis for a given patient is lung cancer, that's a serious matter. So a testing or treatment plan should depends both on probabilities and utilities, and current medical expert system can take into account the value of information to recommend test and then describe a differential diagnosis. So so above 0.8% of children are born with heart anomalies, and the most common being aortic or aortic cortisation, aortic cortisations, a construction of the aorta, and it can be treated with surgery and angioplasty and or medication. So the problem is to decide what treatment to use and when to do it. So the younger the infant, the greater the risk of certain treatments, but one must not wait too long. And decision theoretic expert system for this problem can be created by a team consisting of at least one domain experts a pediatric cardiologist and one knowledge engineer, and the process can be broken down into the following steps. So first, create a casual model, determine the possible symptoms, disorders, treatments and outcomes, and then draw arc between them and indicating what disorders cause what symptoms and what treatment alleviate what disorders. Some of these may will be well known to the domain's experts, and some will come from the literature, and often the model will match well with the informal graphical description given in medical textbooks. Second, simplify to a qualitative decision model. Since we are using model to make treatment decisions and not for other purposes, and we can also simplify by removing variables that are not involved in treatment decisions, and sometimes variable will have to be split or joined to match the expert institution. And for example, the original aortic aortic coarctation model had a treatment variable with value surgery, angioplasty and medication, and separate variable for timing of this treatment. But the expert had a hard time thinking of this separately, so they were combined with treatment taking on values such as surgery in 1 month, and this gives us the model of figure here. You can see influence diagram for aortic coarctation. So difficult to pronounce. So we can, in short, we can say this disease as AC. Okay, so assigned probabilities and probability can come from patient databases and literature studies or the expert subjective assessment. So here is the third, assigned probabilities. And note that a diagnosis system will reason from symptoms and other observation to the disease or other cause of the problems. Thus, in the early years of building these systems, experts were asked for the probability of a cause given an effect. In general, they found this difficult to do and were better able to assess the probability of an effect given a cause. And so modern system usually access casual knowledge and encode it directly in the Bayesian network structure of the model, and leaving the diagnostics reasoning to the Bayesian network inference algorithm. So next one is assign utilities. When there are a small number of possible outcomes, they can be enumerated and evaluated individually using the method earlier we described, and we would create a scale from best to worst outcomes and give such give each a numeric value. For example, 0 for death and 1 for complete recovery. So we would then place the other outcomes on this scale, and this can be done by the expert, but it is better if the patients can be involved, and because different people have different preferences, if there are exponentially many outcomes, we need some way to combine them using multi attributes utility function. And so for example, we may say that the cost of various complications are additive. And next one is verify and refine the model. So to evaluate the system, we need a set of correct input and output pairs and so-called gold standard to compare against. And for medical expert system, this usually means assembling the best available doctors, presenting them with a few cases and asking them for their diagnosis and recommended treatment plan. We then see how well the system matches their recommendation. If it does poorly, we try to isolate the parts that are going wrong and fix them, and it can be useful to run the system backward instead of presenting the system with a symptoms and asking for a diagnosis. So we can present it with a diagnosis such as heart failure and examine the predicted probability of symptoms such as tachycardia and compare with the medical literature. And next, perform sensitivity analysis. This important step checks whether the best decision is sensitive to small changes in the assigned probabilities and utilities by systematically varying those parameters and running the evaluation again. If small changes lead to significantly different decisions, then it could be worthwhile to spend more resources to collect better data. And if all variations lead to the same decision, then the agent will have more confidence that it is the right decision. And sensitivity analysis is particularly important because of one of the main criticism of probabilistic approach to expert system is that it is too difficult to assess the numerical probabilities required. And sensitivity analysis often reveals that many of the numbers need to be specified only very approximately. And for example, we might be uncertain about the conditional probability. So probability tachycardia given to dyspnea, and but if the optimal decision is reasonably robust to small variation in the probability, then ignorance is less of a concern. So here you can see the influence diagram for aortic corcutations, difficult to pronounce. So there is a system and treatment. You can see here heart failures, and so there is intermediate results also. So that's all for this session. The session ended here. Thank you.